So I want to talk about vitamin A. There's a lot of benefits from vitamin A, not just for your immune system, but especially for your vision. If you're deficient, you'll have a hard time seeing at night. And if you're very deficient, you can even go blind. Vitamin A also is essential for the inner skin, the inside of your sinuses, your throat, your lungs, your digestive system. So without enough vitamin A, you get chronic sinus issues. You have skin issues on the outside of your body as well as on the inside. But here's the problem. A lot of people think they can get enough vitamin A from veggies, despite the recent alteration in the definition of vitamin A. But a true vitamin A is retinol. So retinol is the active form of vitamin A. So there's some confusions on vitamin A. Is it a precursor? Is it an active form? So I wanted to tell you that when you think of vitamin A, always think of the active form retinol, not the precursor. Why? Because at best, you're only going to convert 3% of your precursors or beta carotene to retinol. But on top of that, up to 45% of the entire population has a defect, a genetic defect in the conversion of the pre-vitamin beta carotene to retinol. Let's take a look at what it would take, what you would have to eat to get 9,000 micrograms of vitamin A active retinol. Beef liver, only 3 ounces. Cooked carrots, you'd have to consume 4.4 pounds of cooked carrots to get this much retinol, if you were lucky. Raw carrots, you'd have to consume 40 pounds. Now, that's a lot of carrots. I mean, I can see consuming maybe 20 pounds of carrots in one sitting, but 40 pounds? That's significant. Then we have cooked kale, 50 cups you'd have to consume to get this much retinol. Raw kale, 454 cups. That's a lot of kale. So guess what? You're not going to get your vitamin A from vegetables. Now, there's a lot of benefit to beta carotene, but to get enough bioavailable retinol, you're going to have to get it from non-plant sources, as in cod liver oil, or grass-fed liver, or raw milk cheese, or grass-fed butter. And by the way, out of all the dairy out there, sheep cheese has the highest amount of retinol. However, based on the study that I'm going to put down there on sheep cheese, there is another animal that will produce the same retinol as sheep milk, and that is the rat. But the problem nowadays, it's very difficult to get enough milk from your pet rat. So I would just go with the sheep cheese. It's much easier. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the U.S. Hopefully, in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.